Hey, this is Ralph, and in this video I'd like to go over the @media rule. Okay, so I've got a web page set up, and if you were using multiple CSS files, which is not the norm, you could, in theory, put a media attribute right inside of there. So I could have one CSS file for media equals print, and then I could have another CSS file for media equals screen. Of course, these would be two different CSS files. But that's not done quite so much anymore. Instead, we'll often use @media rules in order to break up our one CSS file into multiple sections, meaning I don't need that media attribute in there. By the way, if you don't use a media attribute, it means media all, works for all things equally. But we're going to go ahead and change that. So here's my CSS file. I can go ahead and write out @media screen. And then that gets a set of curly braces, just like any other CSS rule. So @media screen. And then I'll put in a rule for the body of the page, font family Verdana. Now let's compare this to @media screen, set of curly braces, and then I'll have another of a body rule within this, font family times. So basically, my web page is going to use a couple of rules. In fact, I don't really even have any navigation, so that's not too practical, but I do have this image. So any of the rules outside of a @media rule are going to be used by all levels. Okay. However, on screen, the body of the page is going to have a Verdana font. Oops, and I made a mistake there. @media print. On print, I'm going to use a Times New Roman font. I'm going to go ahead and save that. Head over to my browser and refresh, and there's my Verdana font. But if I go to my browser and I go into print mode, we'll see it's now a Times font. Let's try another variation. So now I'm going to go to @media screen and I'm going to do a set of parentheses. And within these parentheses, I'll do orientation portrait. Once again, a set of curly braces. And I'll do something really obvious. I'll take my body background color and make it orange. So what this is saying is that if my web page is being viewed on a screen and the orientation of the device is in portrait mode, taller than it is wider basically, then the body background color is going to change to orange. I'm going to go ahead and save that. Back to the browser, refresh. Well, no orange background now, but I'm in landscape mode. If I made my browser narrower than it is wide, now I'm in portrait mode by the device's standards, and I get that orange background color. Let's go a step further. @media screen and max width, I'll do 500 pixels. Create a rule for the body. Background color, this time I'll go to, let's do something really obvious. I'll do green. Okay, got that. Saved. Browser refresh. Now it's green. But check this out. If I go about here, let's see, because I want to show you a point to where I can make it portrait, getting the orange background, but clearly it's wider than 500 pixels. But if I go narrower, then it switches to green. So we can have our landscape, which is no background color, portrait, which is orange, or less than 500 pixels, now it's green. So using these various techniques, you can dramatically change the style of your web page based on what kind of device the person is using. Particularly, what you're most interested in is the width of that device screen. Now all this is going to be helped by putting in that meta viewport too. This is another kind of requirement for making any responsive site. But as long as you're putting that meta viewport, width equals device width, initial scale 1, in all of the head sections of all of the web pages you create, now you can start to experiment with various @media rules for customization. And at the very end, I basically want to point out that as you're using at media, you have two schools of thought. You can design from the small leading to the big, or from the big leading to the small. So what that means is, just kind of ignore all of this stuff for a second. I'll zoom in here. First, I might design for my small devices. Any rules, and just kind of pretend that I've got here, I'll have CSS rules for all devices, small to large. And then later on, I might go into at media, screen, and min width 400px. Now in this area, I'm going to put in extra rules that will count for devices that are at least 400 pixels wide. And then I'd go a step further, say, okay, I'm taking care of my handheld phones, things like that, smartphones. Then I might do a min width of about 700 pixels to start dealing with tablets and things like that. And then I might go a step further and put in something like 1100 pixels. Now I'm in desktops and things like that. So I'm dealing with CSS rules for all devices, then CSS rules for my mobile devices and smartphones, CSS rules for my tablets, and then CSS rules for desktops and certainly anything wider than that. This is basically the mobile first methodology of design. Take care.